Okay, hello guys, it's another word of the day. I'm going to show you how to screencast your Android phones on your laptops or desktops. It is easy now, you can do it. Or yeah, for example, this mostly is used by developers who need to debug here or test their apps they are developing. It will be short and precise video with the so one thing you need to have, or of course, is an Android phone, and this phone should have an Android version of 5 plus or upwards. Then the second option you should have is a developer option enabled. In case this option is not enabled, you should go to settings, about the phone option, and build number, and press the build number option 5 times. Developer option should be activated. After you are done with that, go back to the phone, and you should see the developer option available. Enable it and scroll down, and you should also enable the USB debugging option. Then after you are done with that, you should download the source CPY from the link in the description below and extract it in your folder of your option or of your choice, as I've done here. This is the zipped file. You should extract it, and it should look like this. Then from here, you should open your extracted file, and in this file path here, you should left click once and type cmd to open it in the command prompt, or cmd in short, and press enter. After you are done that, you should connect your phone using a USB cable or a data cable. When you are done, you should make sure your phone is on. It will pop up some settings asking you to authenticate the key, which will be presented when you launch this software. So you should type SC source CPY dot EX, or in short, you can write SC, then press the tab key on your keyboard, and it will autocomplete for you. Then press enter. When you press enter, you should see your phone on. If you are doing this for the first time, they will present you with those options to accept the authentication key. You should press always allow for this device to connect. And after you have allowed it, you should see your phone reflecting on your laptop or on your desktop. Then from there, you can start interacting with your phone. For example, we can go to the settings. It will open like this. Okay, let's assume we are now on our phone, physical phone. So the option we are talking about here, about the phone, the phone. For you to have this developer option enabled, you should go to this option about phone here, and then press this option build number for 5 times. In my case, you can see here it is telling me that no need, you are already a developer here. But if you are not, you should press this option for 5 times. For instance, if you want to go back from here, you can see you don't have buttons to go back to the main screen or the main menu. For you to go back, you should press Alt key on your keyboard and then backspace combined. auth plus backspace, and it should go back to where it was. Yeah, it is as simple as that. You can explore more on this software. For example, let's go back and exit this by pressing Ctrl C on our keyboard. Ctrl C, and it should disappear. Our phone should disappear from the main screen. For you to explore or see more options, you should like source, press tab key, then space, two hyphens, and type help. You should see all help describing on how you are going to read or operate your phone. Always on top, you can use this option. Makes source by Windows always on top above other windows. For instance, we can use the rotate option. Who is it? For instance, we can use this rotation value. Set the initial display rotation. Possible values are 0, 1, 2, and 3. Each increment adds a 90 degrees rotation counterclockwise. For instance, let's say we want to rotate our screen, our phone, our 90 degrees to appear on our screen. What are we going to do? We are going to type to call the software, and that then add this option. We should copy here. Control C to copy, then go here to the command source, tab, then space, paste our option, and then rotation value we should put 1, and press enter on here on a keyboard. What is the problem? Error. We encountered an error. Let's try again. Don't know why it is not working on my side, but okay. Let's see. I made a mistake somewhere. Should put a value direct here. Yes, you should delete this value here. Yes, as you can see, our phone has appeared in a 19 degrees counterclockwise or left. Or you can else press out on your keyboard and press the left or right side key. They should do the same work. Control C to lock, then open again. Another thing, let's open it. If you don't have, for example, let's say you don't have a webcam on your machines or laptop or desktop, you can record directly using your phone. For instance, although I'm not going to record myself, you can switch on the camera and put it in a location where it will be accessible, and it will start recording. And you can switch the selfie camera and the back camera. Then from there you can record yourself at a position, which is well lighted. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share with others. See you next time. Goodbye.